Good morning, Jesus. Oh, my Jesus, sweet prisoner of love, here I am before you again. I left you saying goodbye, and now I come back saying good morning. I was anxiously burning to see you again in this prison of love, to give you my yearning obsequies, my affectionate heartbeats, my ardent desires, and all of myself, in order to transfuse myself completely in you, and to abandon all of myself in you, in perpetual memory and pledge of my love toward you. Oh, my always lovable sacramental love, you know, while I have come to give you all of myself, I have also come to receive from you all of yourself. I cannot live without a life. Therefore, I want yours. All is given to one who gives all. Isn't it true, O Jesus? Therefore, today I will love with your heartbeat of a passionate lover. I will breathe with your panting breath in search for souls. I will desire your glory and the good of souls with your immeasurable desires. All the heartbeats of creatures will flow within your divine heartbeat. We will grasp them all. We will save them. We will let no one escape at the cost of any sacrifice, even if I should bear all the pain. If you should push me away, I will fling myself deeper inside. I will cry out louder in order to plead together with you the salvation of your children and my brothers. Oh, my Jesus, my life and my all, how many things does your voluntary imprisonment tell me? But the emblem with which I see you all studded is the emblem of the soul, and the chains which bind you completely, so very tightly, are love. It seems that the words souls and love make you smile, debilitate you, and force you to surrender in everything and I, pondering well these excesses of your love, will be always around you and together with you with my usual refrains, souls and love. Therefore, today I want all of you, always together with me in the prayer, in the work, in the pleasures and displeasures, in the food, in the steps, in the sleep, in everything. I am certain that, being unable to obtain anything by myself, with you I will obtain everything, and everything we will serve to soothe each of your pains, to sweeten every bitterness of yours, to repair for any offense, to repay you for everything, and to impetrate any conversion, no matter how difficult and desperate. We will go begging for a little love from every heart to make you more content and happy. Isn't it good like this, O Jesus? O dear prisoner of love, bind me with your chains, seal me with your love. O please, show me your beautiful face. O Jesus, how beautiful you are. Your blonde hair braids and sanctifies all of my thoughts. Your forehead, calm and serene, in the midst of so many offenses, gives me peace and puts me in the most perfect calm, even in the greatest storms, of your very privations, of your whims, which cost me my life. Ah, you know it, but I move on. It is my heart that tells you this, for it knows how to say it better than I do. Oh, love, your beautiful, cerulean eyes, sparkling with divine light, abduct me to heaven and make me forget the earth. But alas, to my greatest sorrow, my exile yet continues. Hurry, hurry, O Jesus. Yes, you are beautiful, O Jesus. I seem to see you in that tabernacle of love. The beauty and the majesty of your face enamors me and makes me see heaven. Your gracious mouth kisses me softly in every instant. Your gentle voice calls me and invites me to love every moment. Your knees sustain me. Your arms clasp me with indissoluble bond, and I will impress my burning kisses, thousands upon thousands, on your adorable face. Jesus, Jesus, may our will be one, one our love, one our contentment. Never leave me alone, for I am a nothing, and the nothing cannot be without the all. Do you promise me, O Jesus? It seems that you say yes. And now, bless me, bless all, and in the company of the angels, of the saints, of the sweet Mama, and of all creatures, I say to you, good morning, O Jesus, good morning.